Good afternoon. My name is Albert Mutesasra. I work as a software developer with ESP Uganda. Now, as you might be familiar, earlier Monica talked about the integrated primary Tamli tool that was customized into the DHIS2. So I'm here to show you how we visualize that data in the system. Yeah. So we leverage on the powerful analytic capabilities of DHIS2, to kind of dive into a deeper insights and analysis of these tools and try to visualize these indicators. So this is a dashboard showing you some data that was entered last year. And as you can see, this dashboard, it's sectioned into different sections. You can see the reporting rates, as a section. You can see the enrollment, some of them are loading. You can see sections like absenteeism for the learners, etc. As you can see, these nice dashboards. So we can look at these indicators in to analyze. We kind of get this data to kind of drive positive outcomes and drive decision making for the supervisors. So I don't want to go so much into this because we have very little time, but I want to show you how we can use these dashboards to kind of drive this decision making. Now with this dashboard, you can share this dashboard like this to the fellow system users who are registered in the system. That is one. And you can also share these dashboards to users that are outside the system. You can do this by printing the dashboard like this. You can go to more here. Then you say, I want to print this dashboard. So now when you print, when you click on print, it will ask you whether you want to get the whole dashboard layout or just one item per page. In this way, you can print a PDF version of this dashboard and email it to maybe supervisors to help in driving decision making and maybe have some positive outcomes out of this. Let us see how this will look like if we do the dashboard layout. If I do something like that, it will look something like this. So it is the exact same dashboard in the system, only that this is a PDF version. So we can print this. Yes, and share. It can be on mail or any other ways of sharing. And this will help us in driving decision making. Now, the sharing also facilitates monitoring and evaluation to monitor progress towards the goals that have been set by maybe the users of these dashboards. Also, sharing helps us in effective resource allocation. Earlier on, Monica showed you a map of some district in Uganda, whereby there are we saw bigger numbers in some sub-county in Uganda, whereby we saw a big number of learners that were absent in a certain period of time. So such dashboards help us to look at those numbers and see what is the problem, why are learners absent, why is there a big number of absent learners in this in this particular sub county, and that will help the decision makers to maybe concentrate in that sub county in terms of resource allocation. It also helps us in building capacity. In capacity building, because now these dashboards, if we download and share them, they can help us in trying to build capacity of these users here to know where to concentrate on, etc. There is more to this on how to create all these dashboards, how to create the visualizations, which we shall be talking about in the 3 days of the academy that are starting on Wednesday up to Friday, where we shall be talking about the different charts that are in the DHIS2. Like I said, it's a powerful analytic tool, that ranges, that has different visualizations, and you can visualize anything in here. It ranges from maps, it ranges from bar graph, pivot tables, etc. And we shall be talking about that in detail later on in the week. Thank you so much. That will be all from me.